Hi, Carol here. Welcome to my craft room. Well, today's Friday and I'm supposed to have a video up for Tupelo Designs LLC, but you know what? I was so busy and I only had 2 weeks notice, so I thought I'd run to the dollar store and just show you this video. I got a big bucket here to put my soapy water in when I do my stenciling. I'll throw my stenciling in there. And then I got all this junk here. I got some flowers. I'm sure, you know, everybody's seen flowers. This is for my roses, my flowered roses, where you have to heat set the bottom. And some of these sponge things. And a makeup applicator for my pan pastels. And some of these. Okay, well, thank you so much for joining me. You have yourself a blessed week. And hang on for just a minute. April Fool's Day! I'm glad you stayed to the end because I'm going to show you my video. I just had to throw that in. It's April Fool's Day. My first video for Tupelo Designs LLC is on April Fool's Day. I mean, what else could I do? Hi, Carol here, and I am a guest design team member on Tupelo Designs LLC. And I'm sitting here by my computer, and I am on Tupelo Designs LLC, and look it. I keep going. They have so many products. I keep going down and scrolling and scrolling. And I'm telling you, if you are looking for products, don't go any farther. This store has it all. And if they don't, Jane, Mike, and Dan will help you and see if you can get the product. All you have to do is go on their site and contact them if you can't find something. But I'm telling you, there is so much on here. And I'm so excited. This is my first day as a guest design team member. And I'm sorry about doing my April Fools. I hope you stuck with me at the beginning and you've got this far. I just had to do something. You are going to fall in love with this site, Tupelo Designs LLC. Just hop on over there and check out the product line. It's endless and you will love it. And I want to thank you for having me as a guest designer. It is a privilege. So now let's go over and I will show you what I created this week. I'm going to use the Lawn Fawn Dye and Stamp Set Laundry Mat. It's called Gorgeous. And I'm going to use the Jelly Bean Shakers here. It comes with envelopes and the card and the shaker. And also the element to put in your shaker elements, whatever you want to put inside. I'm going to make my own envelope, and I'm going to do something unique. I saw a video over on Sandy Alnock's site a few weeks ago, and I was inspired by it, and I couldn't wait to try something similar, but with my own style. And it's more of a clean and simple card. Instead of doing mixed media this week, I thought I would go over and do a card. And this is a 2-inch cutout, so if you have any 2-inch die, it will work on these jelly bean cards. Traced out this circle on two other ivory cream stock pieces of paper, and I took out the 2-inch die and cut it out of three sections. And I also, what I ended up doing is taking all these dies, the whole set. And as you can see here, it is right there, 2 inches. And I took every single one of them and I cut out a red and a black portion. So now we're going to use my favorite things, black licorice ink. I love this ink. And you can get all of these products that I mentioned and I have up on my video here over at Tupelo's. I'm stamping it out on the ivory cream cardstock. And you can get basil cardstock. I love it. That's what I use today. And check out the site. You will get all these products. My favorite things inks are over there, this set and die. And also the Milwaukee heat tool. If you don't have a heat tool, you're looking for a good one. I love the Milwaukee heat tool, and you can get that over on Tupelo's. What I really liked over on Sandy's video was the fact that she showed how to get your vanishing point. And I have taken some post-it note, and you put it down on the angles on the washer, like I've done here, and you're going to, I just put it down there so you wouldn't get any on the bottom. I'm going to stamp one on the left right here and one on the right. You can check out Sandy's video under Sandy Almack, and she'll explain it in a slower motion. But what you're doing here is you're taping it down. I'm using some Hero Arts Ultra Fine Embossing Powder. That's also over on Tupelo's. And I love using that embossing powder. And now I'm going to take some Post-it and put it on the top so that I can get the lower sections of the washer right here. And you want to have the washer side by side together. So if you didn't do this and you didn't do it on the lines for your vanishing point, you would have they would look like they're farther apart and they wouldn't be connected. That's what I'm trying to say. We're trying to connect these. And as you'll see when I take the Post-it note off, that's exactly what happens. And I am heat setting it with some VersaMark and the Hero Arts Extra Fine Embossing Powder and my Milwaukee heat tool, and everything, like I said, is over at Tupelo's. And I want to encourage you to go over and check it out and see how the dryers look like they're pushed up one against the other. And now we're going to take a rolling ruler. And this is where we're going to find the vanishing point. We're going to put it on the dryer that comes out at us. See that one section right there of the dryer? You're going to just mark it off up to the top of your cardstock. And there you have the where the two lines meet is your vanishing point. And now I'm going to put these at 1/8 of an inch across for my floor. And it's easier here. I'm going to do a checkered floor. It's easier to do this with a rolling ruler because you can slide it. And I don't know. It's just more manageable. You can measure your floor tiles any size that you want. I chose 1/8 of an inch going across. And now I'm going to join those dots up with the vanishing point at the top where the two lines met. And I'm just sliding it across, and I'm making all of the tiles going vertical, and then I will come across and make them horizontal. So I'm making sure it's right on the point there. See where my finger was there? That is the vanishing point. And now I am just adding the pencil marks, and I'm going to slide the ruler here. I'm trying to decide. Yeah, I missed one right there, a little tiny one. And now is where I decide horizontally where I want to have these squares to be. And you want them to be thin at the top and then get bigger as they come down. And you can see I don't have much room on the bottom. There's your sliding ruler. Once I've connected all of the lines and I've erased the pencil marks, we're going to proceed with our Copic markers. And you can find those over at Tupelo's. I'm telling you, there's everything over there. I really encourage you to go check out the store. You won't be disappointed. And here I am taking, I think it's a C3 and a C5, and that's the cool grays. Yes, three and the five. And I'm going over all the shadow areas, even underneath the washer. And here I missed a little wee square. Now, see right here, I had just filled my markers, some of them, and the red leaked. Yes, so I decided, okay, I'm not doing those washes over again. No way. Actually, I made the two end ones dryers and the middle one a washer. So I decided to make them red and black checkers. Because we found our vanishing point, you're going to notice that the tiles get bigger as they get closer to you. And they work out just perfect. And I just love the look. And I grabbed a different colored red Copic marker. And it worked out very well. It was a lighter, brighter red. And I was really happy with the way it turned out. So I'm going to do the floor here about 1,000 miles an hour. And look at that. I love that checkered floor in red and black, don't you? And I am just filling it in. And we are on our way to have a cute little birthday card. Once I'm finished filling in the red and the black checkers, I grab my glossy accents. And I'm going to fill the floor full of glossy accents so I get that wonderful shine on it and leave it overnight so it will be nice and dry. You want to make sure it's nice and dry before you start coloring. And I took that set that I told you. This is just a plain circle set I had in my stash. And I'm using each one of them, making sure that they're even. I'm taking some medical tape here to hold it down, yes. And you want to make sure they're not close together, because when I put it through my die cutting machine, you don't want it to bounce and you'll wreck your die that way. So make sure they have a little bit of space. And I'm just showing you that beautiful floor, nice and dry. Yes, and now I'm putting the glossy accents up on the buttons. And I use my Copic markers for the little buttons there. And then we are going to proceed with our Prima mixed media watercolor pencils. Love these. They come in, I think, four different cans, four or five, but I always put my pencils in glass jars. And I'm not going to use any water on them. I'm going to use them dry. So I'm using the grays, light and dark, going around the area. This here, I punched out an extra, or I die cut an extra washer. And I'm using the pencils, these Prima pencils, and they're watercolor pencils, and I'm using this Wobble. And we are going to do, this is going to be in the vertical plastic paper I cut out with the 2-inch die to go over top of that washer front loader. Now, something really wonderful about the Vertigo paper is it connects with any type of medium you use, either your Copics or, in my case here, the Prima watercolor pencils. You want to check that over at Tupelo's. They have a wonderful price on these sets. And I'm going to take my mini mister. I'm going to lay out all of the clothing that comes in this set. So crazy cute. I'm going to use my favorite things, inks. One will be lipstick red and the other will be black licorice. And I'm going to do three sets of clothing and color them in. And I just really like this little mini. Number one, I can fit it in the camera. And it's quick and easy, and you can just multiple stamp, which makes it really nice. And here are all of these sets, and you'll know why I had to cut these out later on in the video. So I'm taking my yellow Copic marker, and I'm going to color the top. And I want this card to be nice and bright. And so I thought the blues, the reds, the yellows would make for a nice piece inside the card. What I'm creating right here on the cardstock is for the inside of the card. And I'm taking my grays and my black. I went down with a dark gray to separate the washers. And now the Zig Clean Color Real Brush Pens, the watercolor pens. I love these. And I took my Pico embellisher that I had in my stash. And I'm going over some of the coloring just to bring it out and make it shine and look 3D. And these Zig markers, if you want to have any coloring medium in your craft room and you want to pick just one, I would pick the Zig markers. They have a really ultra fine point. And here on the basket, make sure you remember that in those holes, they're closed. So whatever colors you put on the top, you have to put in the holes of the hamper, right? So it looks like your clothes are down in there. And I'm taking a piece of double-sided tape and putting it on here. And we're going to start with our envelope. And it's going to be, guess what, mixed media. So I laid out some Cosmic Shimmer glue. And you can get that over at Tupelo's as well. And this is the Basil. It's called Flake and Glitter Glue. It's for using with your metallic flakes. And here I just cut all different sizes because I had to do some mixed media here. I'm going to match my colors, and I'm going to use Ranger Mixed Media Set, and this is the grout. And I'm going to grout in between all of these pieces. So you can get either the collage three-piece set, or you can get the grout set. And I'm going to use the Basil Lollipop red paper here, and the yellow and the black. Just beautiful. You can get that at Tupelo's. Everything I'm using, and I mention on the top of the video, you can get over at Tupelo's. It is amazing, all the products that are over there. And I lightly, once the grout was dry, you want to make sure your grout is dry, I went over it with the Zig markers and nothing happens to them at all. And then on the bottom, I went where there wasn't any grout because I am going to push that watercolor down. See how you can see it there? I'm taking some Mod Podge glossy paste, and I'm putting it with my 2-inch brush, just lightly going over because I want it to dry shiny like the inside of the floor. So I put it over the grout, and wait till you see this on the envelope. It's stunning. It looks like a grouted, there's the Mod Podge. It looks like a grouted floor. I put my acrylic big block over top as I put the red and the black rings around, and I used the glue, the liquid glue that you get at Tupelo's. Anything, just about everything I use here you can get over at Tupelo's, and I set inside that little piece so I could see that it fit well, and it did. And then we're going to proceed on. You know, I had to do some type of mixed media, and I decided to do it to leave the card clean and simple and to make the envelope mixed media goodness. Now I'm taking the dies and some medical tape, and I'm putting it onto my plate, running it through my Vagabond. And I had to do 3 of those sets that I stamped out and colored in, and I did them all different. So you have all different colors going on. And here's the little bubbles. I took the little stamp, and I took my licorice, my favorite things, ink, and here's my wonderful heat tool. I love this Milwaukee heat tool. It heats immediately. And I set them aside while I use my Zig markers. Look at that. Look at the little fine point. And then you can take a Uniball white gel pen that you get at Tupelo's. You can get it in silver, white, and gold. They're beautiful. They work wonderfully. And now I'm taking that round piece, the Vertigo plastic that we use the Prima colors on. And now I lifted up this little suds box at the top. I'm adding my Pico embellisher to the dryer front and to the other dryer, and all the way around here where that Vertigo plastic paper is going to be, I had in my stash, and I thought it was just perfect for the front of a washer. I just think I had so much fun doing this, and I'm so thrilled that I'm doing it for Tupelo Designs LLC. Because you can get all of this over there, everything I'm using here. And I took a dark gray Copic marker, because you know I like to go over all the edges of my images that I die cut out. And I'm setting this on the front. So I'm taking some of my glue here, my glossy accents, and putting it down because it adds to the effect of looking like water when that glue dries. It's crazy cute. I mean, it does look realistic, just like there's water in there. And then I take my glossy accents, and I'm putting a little bit of that down there because I'm going to put a sock in the dryer. I cut the arm off of this little shirt so it looks like, you know, you want it to look like they're floating on the inside. Look at the little underwears. Aren't they cute? I like the way the arm is cut off, and it looks like the shirt is really floating around. Isn't that cute? And I put the smile on the underwears there. See, they come with all different facial features in the sets from Lawn Fawn, but I covered it up with some bubbles. I needed more bubbles on there, and I thought I would just stick it on there. It was cute, but I like it that way. And now with this jelly bean front shaker element, I grabbed Stazon, and I just put the stamp on my finger because they're so nice and sticky. They're a very good photopolymer set. And you get this over at Tupelo's. And look at all the bubbles inside there. That way when I put my glass glitter, this is out of my stash, I pour some in there, and then the static of the frame made it, it was just like bubbles. It looked just like, you know, when you shake your laundry detergent, and it looked real. Wait till you see it. It's amazing. I took a piece of black cardstock, the basil you get over at Tupelo's, and I cut a piece to measure the front here. Took my 2-inch die, cut a hole over it, put double-sided tape on, and a round circle. Now, the reason why the red circle's on here, because when I closed it, the hole was too big, because it would show some of the dryer on the left. So what I did is I just put that red ring on the inside of the acetate, and now when you close it, you don't see the dryer that's on the left side. You just see the washer.
So now we're going on to the front. I raised up the laundry hamper on the right corner there, and then underneath I put the other little suds and the dryer sheet box. The suds is raised up as well. I took my W3 and my W5 and I'm just flicking on so it's not floating in the air, and just gave it somewhere to land. And then I end up putting my Pico embellisher around the red circle here so it looked like the floor on the inside of the card. And we're all set. I am thrilled to do this. Thank you so much for having me as a guest designer. I am just over the moon, excited to do projects every Friday. Like every Friday, you'll get a different video from mixed media to clean and simple layouts. I'll mix it all up for you. So I took some black cardstock and I added my anti-static powder to the one side here. I actually did two sides. Just in case I didn't cut it off even, I would have another set to work with. And I think it says, hoping your birthday is loads, of course, loads of fun. Yes, hope your birthday is loads of fun. I love this set. I love the fonts on it. So I cut it off right here. And then I'm just putting some double-sided tape and adding it to it because it gives me something to hold as I'm cutting it as well. It's hard to cut with the trimmer, and you can get the Caterpillar Pro ABS trimmer over at Tupelo's, the large Caterpillar one. I wanted to mention that because that is a wonderful trimmer. You can check that out. And here I used red on the background of the black, and I made my own tag, and I raised up the yellow and black loads of fun. So you had one flat and one raised. And I'm just going to show you here. There's the inside. Isn't it colorful? I just adore it. And now I covered it with my double-sided tape on the inside to add the panel. And we are almost down to the wire here. And look when I shake that. I mean, it looks like you have a laundry washer with clothes in it going around, and it looks like real water with this beautiful vertigo plastic. Now this washer that I decided to do, that I die cut out, I'm using the vertigo plastic, but I'm using Copics this time, and I'm using two different shades of blue, and I'm leaving a little bit of white space. I'm grabbing my Copic here to make sure that I get all the colors. I want it to be just as colorful on the envelope. And I'm taking my little wobble, yeah, and I'm putting it down, making sure it's in the middle, and test out the wobbles so you know which side wobbles the most. And then I add this vertigo paper. And the vertigo paper, the plastic, and it's not paper, it's plastic. It looks like almost like an ocean. It has these waves in them, in the plastic. It's unbelievable. And yeah, I found it in my stash, decided to use it. So then I put my Pico embellisher on there, and my clothes, my sock and my shirt. And now I'm adding the Pico embellisher to the top. You can use glossy accents as well. I go around and make sure all of this is dry because we're going to add that to the envelope we're going to make together. Now we're moving on to making our own envelope. I picked out some yellow 12x12 cardstock and some red, and it's not thin, but it's not ultra thick either. It's perfect consistency for envelopes. And this is a 4.25 by 5.5 inch card. So I made this to be 4.5 by 6. That's the envelope. So I have room. You know, I don't want it to be really snug because of the shaker element. And there you have it. Look at that. And I'm going to make two because I want to, when you open the envelope, I want you to be able to see red. And I cut the paper down to, here it says 4.5 by 6. You cut your paper to 8.5 by 8.5. And you score it each time, well, just the first time actually, at 3.75. And then every time you make a line, I always start my line from the bottom and work my way up to the circle. And don't forget to punch it down so you get those V shapes in the envelope. And here we're going to have the inside flap with the red, and I put my double-sided tape, cut it off. It doesn't have to be perfect because you are going to cut it, and you want it to be pretty close to perfect here, just so when you open it, it's nice and snug. And then I took my my wonderful bone folder right here, and I'm adding a 1/16 of an inch of tape around there. There's my, I love this bone folder because it doesn't leave any marks, and I cut it off straight at the end, and that's for a reason I'll show you once we get going. I pull off the 1/16 of an inch double-sided tape here that's going to close and seal it to make sure it's not on the upper portion. I just peeled it back, just testing it out, and then I'm going to take my bone folder, my Teflon bone folder, because you could press on that thing and your paper's not going to have any waxy residue using that. I wanted to try and use up all of these embellishments that I cut out because it took a lot of work to color those in, and I didn't want to leave any leftover. I ended up with one leftover shirt, but oh well. You always end up with leftover socks, but no, not me. I end up with a leftover shirt. Now I took some acetate and stays on, which you'll get at Tupelo's. All of these products, just go over to the store. If you can't find them, just check it out, because Dan will make sure that he will try his best to get it for you. And Mike and Jane, they are just super duper, and they will help you to any way they can in getting products. And here I put some acetate on the back, covered it fully with double-sided tape, except for on the circle, of course. And now we're making the front of the envelope. And I love the way that the acetate has Hope Your Birthday Is Loads of Fun, as well as the inside of the card. I'm taking that wonderful washer and I'm putting half of it with the roll of double-sided foam tape, and the other I'm using straight runner, and I set it down here with the wobble. Look at it. They're going to have so much fun with the front of it, and they're going to love the inside, I think. Look at, there's my leftover shirt. Come on, where am I going to put that? I love the grouted effect on the card there, the mixed media style, and I love how it blended itself into the clean and simple card. And I had so much fun. And thank you. I will see you next Friday for another project. And please go over to Tupelo's and check all these products out. Look at that. Doesn't it look like a washer? Oh, it's so stinking cute. I just love it. I almost want to hug it. It's so cute. And thank you so much for having me as a guest designer. I look forward to the next project. I have a really nice project in line for next Friday. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for your lovely comments. Have a blessed week. And I hope you enjoyed the pictures.